Did the RV market just pass its peak? Let's talk about it. I'm Jason Epperson, this is RV Miles, and here we talk about the latest in RV and camping news, travel destinations, gear, and a whole lot more. And today, I want to talk about the current market for both new and used RVs, which is about as tight as it's ever been. Two major independent reports analyzing the RV market came out last week, and I think they have some valuable information for folks who are looking for guidance on the right time to buy or sell an RV. But before we take a look, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this video, Wholesale Warranties. The cost of RV repair is only going up. Modern RVs require skilled labor and more technologically advanced parts than ever before, driving up the cost of repairs. Protect yourself from these rising costs with RV coverage you can count on. Wholesale Warranties offers reliable coverage, personalized service, 5-star customer reviews, and the flexibility to take your RV to any licensed repair facility in the U.S. or Canada, including mobile mechanics. Get a free quote by visiting wholesalewarranties.com or give them a call at 800-939-2806 and enjoy peace of mind for the road ahead. The first piece of information I want to look at comes from the vehicle market analysts over at Black Book, as published at rvbusiness.com. Black Book's August market commentary looks at the values of used RVs sold at auctions. No surprise, again, RVs are selling at record values. But the increases are less than they have been, suggesting that perhaps used RV values are reaching a plateau. Right now, used motorhomes are selling at auction for an average of about $69,000, up from about $51,000 a year ago. Used towable RVs are selling at auction for an average of about $24,000, up from just over $18,000 a year ago. Both really high amounts. Both motorized and towable RVs increased in value about $500 in June, and the number of RVs sold at auction is decreasing each month. Black Book says that that's likely due to dealers holding on to their trade-ins. In normal times, a lot of dealers only hang on to a portion of their trade-ins to sell used, and they auction off those that they don't want. They may not be in the greatest condition, or they may be something that they have too many of on their lot. But with new inventory harder to come by, they're hanging on to those used RVs. Now, the second set of data we have comes from J.D. Power, who released an annual mid-year report on the RV industry. J.D. Power looks at average retail value instead of auction prices like Black Book. J.D. Power's analyst concurs with Black Book, saying that standard hitch trailers are selling at a whopping 29.5% higher in the first half of 2021 compared to the same period in 2020. Fifth wheels are up 26.8%, Class A's are up 20.6%, and Class C's are up 23.6%. Smaller RVs are surprisingly coming in higher, with truck campers and pop-up trailers coming in at more than 30% higher than a year ago. So the whole market is highly, highly inflated. Now, there's some news from the automotive industry as well. I'm standing here in Chicago, where the Chicago Auto Show just happened, marking the return of auto shows to the automotive industry. Black Book tracks numbers in the automotive industry on a weekly basis, and last week, used wholesale and retail prices of cars and trucks started to stabilize, although again at a remarkably high plateau. But new car sales are still on a roller coaster as the chip shortage is showing up in those new sales numbers. Used cars and trucks, driven by an extreme shortage of rental returns and limited inventory on new vehicles, have been experiencing large weekly gains ever since the beginning of the year. And wholesale prices are exceeding the MSRP in some cases. The rate of increase started to slow down at the end of June, however, and after 19 weeks of continuous increases, retail prices seem to reach their peak last week in the car and truck industry. Retail prices are around 25% above where they started the year. That's absolutely bonkers. But demand isn't the only thing affecting RV availability. Pricing as well. Issues with the supply chain, of course, and raw material costs have been affecting the market. And we're seeing some changes there too. Lumber prices have been crashing in the last month, back to almost the same point that they were a year ago. So what does this all mean? Well, trying to guess market peaks is a really dangerous game. But we know the RV industry is seasonal, and summer is obviously peak season, which means that prices are high in the summer. Black Book analyst Eric Lawrence says that it's likely that supply is finally catching up with demand in the RV industry, especially on the new side, where factories are producing record numbers of vehicles every month. Catching up with demand doesn't mean prices will substantially drop, but it could mean that we are at the peak. J.D. Power doesn't expect the supply and demand relationship to change much into the fourth quarter. But if we have hit a point where for every new RV buyer, there is a new or used RV coming in, it's possible that the market for RVs, both new and used, has hit its peak. I've been following the number of used RVs available over at RVTrader.com, which is the biggest RV-specific online marketplace. And there has been an increase in used RVs available over the past 3 weeks of about 4.5%, 1,600 units or so. I'd imagine that number will steadily increase over the fall into the winter. But I'd expect it to take a long time before we see inventories returning to normal on dealer lots and in the used market. That's it for this video. If you want to know more about my take on the possibility of a glut of used RVs, check out this one. And here's a video that YouTube thinks you'll like. Isn't that nice of them? See you on the next one.